Smithfield effectively closed long before its noon deadline as workers stopped in the face of apparently unending negotiations and the threat of redundancies. From the early hours there'd been meetings and more meetings, but stalemate was the only thing everyone agreed on. At the centre of the dispute, Allied meat importers, with the smartest store in the market, but a store that's still empty. A van had waited expectantly to be unloaded, in breach of the union monopoly on labour, but in the event it never was. AMI had refused to accept the union nominee for the vacancy they have, so confrontation was inevitable.
And our whole purpose in, if you like, spreading the gospel, if that's the word, is because we believe, really believe, that no one in their right senses could any longer support a claim by any organisation that they are allowed to allocate to any business a individual.
Yet the union has agreed with employers that they should be offered alternative staff if a candidate put forward isn't suitable. But it now hinges on whether it's the union or the managers who decide just who is suitable. Despite restrictive practices, the market has operated virtually trouble-free for 50 years. But the shop tenants have now unanimously backed AMI and the principle of their freedom to choose their own staff. They now present a united front and warn that if staff strike, they won't get their jobs back on time-honoured traditions. Many in the market find Peter Martinelli's publicity-seeking style of management very hard to swallow. But they can't ignore that unless restrictive practices are changed, the planned multi-million pound redevelopment of the market may not go ahead. Now then, it's left to Transport Workers leader Ron Todd to seek a solution on Friday, where others have so far failed. This is Marcus Powell for Thames News.